Hi, welcome to Local Flavor. This is Deborah Anderson, and we're here at Ant Face Community Kitchen in Moreland. Who do I have with me today? Billy Frakes and Sarah Albrecht, and they are the stars of Anything's Possible. Why don't you tell us a little bit about how your family helps with the business?
My husband, he has reluctantly helped bag noodles and tag noodles for me. He's actually a better tagger than a bagger, but and then my son, he likes to come in and cut the long strips of noodles for us
with a pizza wheel.
And my husband has also bagged, and I've come home at different points where he's had everything tagged for me because he knew it was going to be a long day.
Well, he used to be a real chef too, didn't he?
Real chef. Yeah. No, he's an excellent cook.
Yeah. Well, he worked at for restaurants.
And my daughters, I have an 18-year-old and a 17-year-old, and they've taken their fair share of helping make pasta. And the little guy is 6, and he does a really good job of staying out of the way a lot of the time.
Well, sometimes that's what you need out of those ones.
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm.
They're not all good at it. So what are we making with our pasta today?
It's a creamy Cajun pasta called Pastalaya.
Did you make it up, or did you?
This is my own take on Pastalaya. Really is a thing, but I like creamy pasta too, and so I kind of made up my own recipe using the Jambalaya recipe that I was raised with my grandma, that my grandma got from a little old lady in New Orleans that was selling it on a street corner there, and she asked for the recipe, and she didn't want to give it to her, but she said, I promise, I'm not going to compete with you, and gave her address. And a few weeks later, after Grandma got back, this lady really did send the recipe. So this was kind of a spin on that, combined with creamy Cajun pasta. So
awesome.
Kind of my own take on it.
What do you need me to do for you?
Well, we just need to, let's get this turned on here. If I can.
You have to start it on the light.
Okay.
Did it start?
Yes, it did.
Okay.
Mine's just backwards. Okay, so we're gonna start. This is a half a stick of oleo, and use butter, two, whichever you prefer, or whichever you have on hand.
Only my grandma says oleo.
Margarine. So we can start with that, and then I'm going to add I should have had that pan heating ahead of time, huh? I'm going to add one clove of garlic. Now, normally when I do jambalaya or anything, I usually use a lot of garlic. But we're using our garlic and herb pasta today, and
it's pretty heavy on garlic
It's got a lot of garlic in it. So I'm going to go ahead and just add just one clove here.
Do you want this thing to...
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a nice, that's a fresh one.
Yes. And let's see here. And you want to make sure that you don't burn your garlic. It gets really bitter. Oh, I'm sorry about that, Deb.
Burn your garlic or your spatula.
So you just want to really make sure that you're not burning the garlic.
I think it'll be fine. You're just putting one. That's it?
That's it, because there's...
Okay.
There's quite a bit. It's got a lot.
Well, this is a very large pan for one clove of garlic.
Well, we're going to add lots of veggies, and then our sauce is going to cook in here. The pan that's next size down just wouldn't be big enough, so we gotta do that. So we're going to, I know that butter's not quite
It'll be fine.
Melted all the way, but we're going to go ahead and add about 3 ribs of celery diced. And
I like celery cooked, not raw.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I like it both. Celery's got quite a bit of sodium in it too, so it can replace the salt that you add into your dishes, and it adds that extra crunch.
Well, I don't know if I think it'll still need some, don't you? We can still add a little. All right.
We can taste it.
Let's taste it
first.
But
we're gonna have the pasta's already flavored and has some in it, and then we're gonna add our Cajun seasoning here in a little bit too.
Oh, that'll have a lot in it.
Yeah. So this are just some green onions.
This probably is not actually big enough for what I'm using it for.
Do you want this? Yeah, I was just getting the butter out with that. I should have. And I am going to...
How much of did you put in? Three ribs of celery and how? Just
three
one green pepper?
Three ribs of celery and one green pepper.
I love how they're so green when they're fresh. It makes me sad. They taste better cooked down, but it's kind of sad because they're... They lose a little life,
color,
don't they?
Yeah. Now these green onions, I'm going to include some of the green also.
Oh, of course, that's the best part, don't you think?
Yes. Go straight in there.
Well, I've almost got the butter melted.
Good. So then I'm going to add this to it.
More green.
Excuse me, sorry.
Ever since you said jambalaya, I have that Zatarain's commercial going through my head. Zatarain's.
This I've been told by a friend, the green onion, I got a tip in there here.
Don't want that.
The green onion, celery, and peppers, she told me that's the holy trinity of Cajun cooking.
These things, that, celery, peppers,
things,
and onion.
That's what I told. Awesome. Celery, onions, and green onions, and bell pepper.
Very nice. Okay. What's in, now, do we just need to saute
need
this for a bit?
Yes, we need to saute that for
Should
a
we take a break right now while this saute's down? Let's take a short break, and when we come back, we'll start adding the good stuff. Well, this is good, too, but we'll start in. I really like the sausage. Okay, I'll see you then.
Western Auction and Real Estate LLC is ready to travel to you. Their team includes auctioneers and real estate specialists that will exceed your expectations. They offer experience in agriculture real estate, commercial and residential sales, and farm equipment auctions. Plus, they conveniently travel to your location. And it doesn't stop there. Visit westernauctionandrealestate.com today to shop their online equipment auctions too. For professionalism from concept to completion, it's Western Auction and Real Estate.
There's no reason to dread tax season this year with Weller's Tax and Accounting Service on your side. But tax preparation and planning are just a small portion of what we can do for you. Our firm offers a wide range of services to custom fit your individual needs, including payroll services, bookkeeping, IRS representation, financial statements, business consulting, budgeting, and much more. Weller's Tax and Accounting Service, large enough to offer you what you need, but small enough to give you the attention you deserve.
Psalm 91:4 says, "And under his wings you may seek refuge." There is an organization close to home, ready to help victims of domestic violence called Under His Wings. They are privately funded and not government regulated for your privacy and protection. Under His Wings serves Graham, Rooks, Osborne, Norton, Phillips, and Smith counties. If you or your family are needing support or a safe haven, call 785-434-6789. Under His Wings, you may seek refuge.
T-Max Trucking, LLC delivers service you can depend on and serves all of Northwest Kansas. They have shale pits located from Logan to Waukini that provide convenient access to your location. T-Max Trucking specializes in road maintenance and they have a dozer, dump truck, backhoe, and grader to get the job done right. Their locally based business was established in 2012 and is both licensed and insured. Let T-Max Trucking, LLC deliver service you can depend on.
Welcome back to Local Flavor. We are making the Creamy Pastalaya, which is jambalaya made with pasta. Righto? Did I get it? Yeah. Okay, and we have been letting these saute for quite a while. And what are we going to add next, Sarah?
Okay, now we're going to add 2 cans of diced tomatoes. I like the petite diced tomatoes, personally. And then we're going to add, this is 2 cups of chicken broth, which I use a chicken base, so you can use your favorite chicken base, and 1 cup of water. We're going to add that.
So it's really 3 cups of water and some chicken base,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
I like chicken base too. You know the story.
And
they have a lot of flavor compared to the ones in the
do.
Can.
They do. And then I'm going to add 2 teaspoons.
This is your Cajun seasoning.
Slap your mama.
I have some.
So whatever your favorite Creole seasoning is. So I'm going to add 2 teaspoons, which I personally like it spicier than just the 2 teaspoons, but I've got little guy at home and kids.
Yep, it has the shrimp dip on it. I just wanted to see if it still had the shrimp dip.
Yep.
Shrimp dip.
So
good.
Just to make it, and last week I made this out at my sister's house, and my one-year-old little niece was just eating the pasta like crazy. And so I try to go a little less spicy, and then you can always add more, sprinkle some on top. I just put this on the table, and people can spice it up as much
good,
as they
thinking.
Want. Mm-hmm. Yep. So then I'm going to add some bay leaves.
These are fresh.
These are fresh bay leaves. And I usually only add 2. Some of these are, couple of these are pretty small, so I'll add 3. But you don't have to add as much with the fresh ones as you do with the, and I try to,
do you mind
if I steal that?
Yeah, go ahead.
I try to kind of.
You break them? You don't pick
them
out
at
the end?
It's not going to break it. It's just kind of breaking the cells on the outside of the leaf.
Oh my goodness.
To where it gets more of the flavor into your.
I like bay leaf.
I do too.
Did you see, I saw on the internet where somebody was making a complaint because she found a leaf in her food. Did you see that?
See, and I always think like it should be, have you ever seen, well, since this is a Cajun dish, you know the bread that they have, what is that called? For like Mardi Gras and there's a baby in it.
A king cake,
bread or something like that. And whoever gets the little baby has to host the next year or whatever. I think like whoever gets a bay leaf like should have to do the dishes or something.
Oh, that's mean. You already have to pick it out.
Okay, so we're going to do that. And then I'm going to add the sausage here. I'm going to cut that up. And this is just a regular link of smoked sausage. You could use kielbasa too if you wanted, or Polish sausage. But I always like to cut my sausage lengthwise first.
Be careful.
I will.
You feel safe?
Yes, I'm good to go here. So I like to cut mine lengthwise. And I guess this just goes back to when my grandma always just cuts it into little rings. And it just always seemed like people were fighting to get, you know.
Oh, enough pieces?
To get
somebody
pieces.
Got all.
Yeah, so it was like people were sad that they weren't getting. So I decided to just start cutting mine up and cutting it half lengthwise worse so there was more little pieces to.
Yeah, and
disperse.
It's easier to manage. And sometimes you have trouble with the casing too, so that would make it a little easier. I really love this stuff, and we like to cut it into rings and then fry it until it's really crispy.
Yes, so. I try to keep this on hand all the time because especially like on a busy weeknight, it's just so easy to throw into a dish for your meat.
And it lasts a long time.
Just some fried potatoes in
It lasts forever. So after you put that in, let me ask you again about the Anything's Possible, because this is actually a real business that you two are doing, right?
We are. Yes. We just started doing some wholesale marketing and reaching out to different vendors, and it is definitely a different beast, this wholesale, rather than just retail, so it's a lot of learning.
Oh, okay. So when you're saying retail, that's like when you're just selling it yourself.
To the end customer,
right.
And the wholesale is, we've never done that before, so
now,
we're learning.
Are you going to be like, remember when you'd see the commercial for the Chia Pet and it said, available exclusively at Walgreens and Sam's and all that?
Eventually,
are you,
we hope to be like that.
But are you going to be exclusive, or you will sell it anywhere?
I think we kind of like the feel of like specialty stores, gourmet food stores, things like that. But we
won't turn anyone
down. I don't
think
we'll turn anyone down. So I've just added that sausage, and we're just going to let this simmer. Might turn this up a little bit, too. We're going to let this simmer until the sausage, you can kind of see when it kind of takes on a different shape. It kind of bends a little. And then we'll add our chicken.
Oh, chicken and then cream cheese too, right?
Yes.
So, Sarah, you used to make, you guys make your pasta here now at mm-hmm. Amphase Community Kitchen, mm-hmm. which is a business incubator, kind of, or an incubator kitchen.
Kitchen.
Mm-hmm. But you've also maintained your own facility to do it. What is the difference? Which do you prefer better, to have your own facility or to use this?
This, because it is just, it is really hard to, in order to be compliant, you have to have 3 separate sinks just for your dishes. You have to have a 4th one to wash your hands. You have to keep all of your stuff separate from the things for your, like if you had your kitchen in your home, you have to have 2 separate refrigerators, your things can't, your...
And also people coming in and out,
right.
too.
Right, it's really hard to keep it...
You know, the keep inspector, it. She actually had a funny thing that she said. She said, in your home kitchen, you have pets, kids, and a husband, and all of which 2 are usually sticky. Like, well, yeah, that's really true.
That really is, yeah. So, but this is... And the space, I mean, just the space alone, it's just so nice, because it really does take a lot of room to do pasta efficiently as a business, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So it's been wonderful.
The space, and then also, you're just paying an hourly rate here, and you don't have to worry about the bills and the monthly rent. You just only pay for the time you're using it. So.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
That's
got to be a huge help.
Yes, and they have... pretty much everything you need here too, equipment-wise, utensils.
Yeah, another thing is if we were to try to do this someplace else, we wouldn't be able to do it in the quantity that we're doing now. We can get in here, get it done, and get out.
Okay, it looks like our sausage is...
Is it curling?
Perfect. Yeah, it starts to plump and curl a little bit. And at this point, then we're going to add the chicken. And it is already cooked.
Oh, you
pre-cooked
it.
And diced here, yes. So it's 2 cups of cooked chicken. This, I actually cooked this in my sister's pressure cooker. I don't have one yet, but I'm thinking I'm going to have to get one.
Well.
And so I just cooked extra.
Does she have a big one or a little one?
Well, I guess that's the first one ever. It's probably about this.
Is it electric?
Big. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And
so you cooked extra up from, you were making something else?
And throw it in the freezer. Or a lot of times when we are grilling chicken, I'll always throw on some extra chicken breast on the grill and then save it for either jambalaya or fajitas or whatever. I like to grill once and eat twice.
Yeah.
So do that with steak and things like that too. So, or cook in that pressure cooker. I mean, you can cook quite a bit and then just divide it into freezer bags and just have it ready for a busy night.
Did you still season it even though it was in the pressure cooker?
Just salt and pepper.
Just salt. Okay.
That's all I did. So
we'll go. Then did you use all the rest of it to make some stock or not?
There really wasn't much water in
it.
I have to be real honest, my sister kind of took over that part because I'd never used one before, so there really wasn't a whole lot of water in there.
But was it boneless chicken or just breasts?
It was bone-in breast because that's what was on sale, so that's what I bought. So
that looks great.
Yeah, and then we're going to add some cream cheese to this. This is a full package of cream cheese. You could do less if you like it less creamy, but I just say, what the heck? And really, if you, you know, divide out your portion of what you're getting, it's probably no more than what you'd put on a bagel anyway. So
we will live.
That's what I'm going with anyway.
This is my big theory on, you know, you go to those Pampered Chef parties and whatever they make is so delicious. And I've noticed they all have cream cheese.
Yep. Yeah. Okay. Can't go wrong with cream cheese, that's for sure.
So it must be pretty ubiquitous.
Yeah.
So do we need to let this simmer for a bit?
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and keep on letting this simmer and keep on stirring until that cream cheese all melts and kind of incorporates, and then we'll continue to let it cook a little bit until it gets a little bit thicker.
And then what do we do? When do we put the pasta in it?
Then we will just plate the pasta and put this over
it. Oh, okay. Very good.
You can mix it if you want. And actually, I've done a one pot. I can do this as a one pot thing too. It's maybe just not appealing to the eye for TV. But if you decide to do that, you can put two cans of tomatoes, 2 cups of broth, and then 2 cups of water. And
The pasta will absorb that extra cup.
Yes.
I hear ya.
It'll absorb that extra. And so you can do that too if you want a one pot dish.
Well, let's let this simmer for a while and take a little break. And when we come back, we will try to cook the pasta into it. What flavor pasta are we using?
Garlic and herb.
Okay, well, we'll be right back and I'll show you it.
Make moving and storing your home or business easy with Storage Solutions of Hayes and Victoria. With 2 facilities, they can store anything from antiques to automobiles and everything in between. Interior units for items needing special care. Drive-up units of all sizes, perfect for home or business. And outside storage for trucks, boats, and RVs. As an authorized U-Haul dealer, they have everything for your next move, across town or across the country. Storage Solutions of Hayes and Victoria, making moving and storing easy.
Hi?
We're looking for insurance.
Let's see who's free.
Jerry?
When insurance agents work for only one company,
Michael!
Their options are simply limited.
Everybody!
But a Trusted Choice independent agent is free to shop many companies for a better deal. Free to do what's right for you.
Let us shop for you. Contact Rogers & Associate to learn more.
What a girl wants in her home kitchen. Ease of use, flexibility, fun, the latest kitchen design, Frigidaire Professional Real Stainless Steel for fewer finger smudges, a French door refrigerator, convection cooking, a quiet dishwasher. Have the staff at Genuine Appliance in Hayes demonstrate new Frigidaire Professional appliances to find what you want. Genuine Appliance at 1224 East 27th in Hayes. Everything a girl wants.
The Rusty Tractor in Kensington offers big city dining with a small town feel. The Rusty Tractor features hand-cut steaks, burgers, wraps, and more, all with generous portions and quality products. The Rusty Tractor is proud to serve the area farming communities and welcomes everyone. Come as you are in your boots and jeans. You'll be right at home. Open daily and conveniently located on Highway 36. For more information, find them on Facebook. Or for a full menu, visit RustyTractorKensington.com.
Welcome back to Local Flavor. We have been cooking our sauce and our pastalaya, and the pasta is also already cooked. And this is the garlic and herb flavor.
Yes.
Is this a popular one?
It is by far our most popular one.
The most popular one? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Why do you think?
I think people can relate to it more. They don't really have to think so much outside of the box to use it, you think?
Yeah, and it's probably, a lot of people ask if we make just plain pasta, and it's probably the closest, you know, to a plain pasta.
You can substitute it. And like even just something as simple as chicken noodle soup. You start putting that in it and you can't go back.
My friend Naomi said that's what she does. Well, you better get this dumped because I think it is.
Okay.
I don't want it to get waterlogged.
And while she's doing this, I guess I'm feeling nice.
Thank you,
miss.
I'll take
out all the bay leaves so no one has to do the dishes.
You'd think if you're paying rent here, it should come with dishwashing. Just kidding. You have to do your own dishes.
All right. So I have that. And when she brings that pasta back, then we'll go ahead and plate that.
Are we going to use bowls this time?
Sure.
Are we going to use a fork to eat it or spoons?
A fork, probably.
Okay.
So if you want to grab the... Do you want to...
Do pastas? Okay.
Now,
if this was real life and it was regular jambalaya, we would be putting rice, right? Or does the rice get in
it? The rice goes in and
I'll just make it a small amount.
Cooks.
I bet the hardest one for people to get used to is the smoky barbecue.
You know, it really was, but we had the people that tried it absolutely loved it. We made a, I made a barbecue ranch pasta salad with it. What all did we put in that?
Celery, onions,
corn.
There's some tomatoes.
Yeah, tomatoes and black beans.
Is that on your website?
It is.
On your Facebook
page?
Or on
our Facebook page, yeah. Yeah. There you go. And here is some extra if you want.
Ta-da.
Fork.
Thank you.
Let's see if you want any extra.
I'm getting right on it.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
It is really good.
Mm-hmm. Good.
I love my sausage.
And I think almost any of our flavors could go in this too. The tomato basil or even maybe the spinach pasta.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can use any of them in there.
Oh, let's make something with the spinach. Will you guys come back?
Sure, absolutely.
Awesome. We'll see you next time on Local Flavor.